So I've got a bit of a bonus video for you today, because in yesterday's HDMI video, I touched on a feature that left many of you pleasantly surprised, with some of you reaching out and asking for further elaboration and potentially some demonstration of this feature. And the feature that we're talking about is in the latest Sony cameras, like the Sony A7 III, using Face Detect Autofocus while having an external device connected over HDMI. So I'm going to demonstrate how that feature works and prove, I guess, essentially that it does work in today's video. Let's get undone. What is happening, everybody? I'm Gerald Undone, and it seems like yesterday's video has a few of you wanting to see a little bit more proof, if you will, of one of the features that I touched on. Take Peter Gregg, for instance. You guys know Peter Gregg, right? He's this guy.
Hey, Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Welcome to the Christmas room.
Well, even he commented asking, hey, Gerald, I've been telling people on my channel, and so have dozens of others, that Sony blocks face detection when recording to an external monitor or if you use Wi-Fi. And then he went on to ask if I could set up another camera to capture the back of the screen, showing that the box is working and that it's focusing and all that. And so that's what we're going to do today, and I'm happy to demonstrate it, but I do just want to clear one thing up just in case there was any confusion. I suggested in yesterday's video that if you disable internal recording and you only record to an external device, an external recorder, that then you can use face detection AF in 4K. Any time that you record internally, you won't be able to use it. So if you're just using an external monitor and you're just monitoring it, but you want to record inside the Sony, that's no bueno. You have to have a external recorder actually capturing it and not be recording to the Sony. And I'll demonstrate how to set that up and prove that it works right now. Okay, so to get this to work, just like in yesterday's video, we're gonna have to go into the setup screen, and it's gonna be setup for page 4 of the yellow toolbox there where it says 4K output select. We're gonna choose that. And we're going to choose HDMI only, 24p, or you could do 30p if you want to, but I'm going to use 24p. This disables the internal recording, so if we jump over to setup 3 and go to the bottom of HDMI settings, we can see here that we can't change the output, we can't put on info display, and we can't change the resolution, but we can still use the TC output and we can still use the record control. And then if we go to the video settings, first page here, you can also see that you can't change the file format and you can't change the record setting either. And now if we go to page 6 on the first tab, which is where Face Detect Autofocus is, you go to set face priority and AF, you can see it's on and it's on. Now just to sort of confirm one more time with you guys about how this works, if you go back over here and you turn and you go to setup 4 and you put this back to memory card and HDMI and then you jump over to where the face detect autofocus would be again, which is on page 6 of the first tab, you can see that you can't turn it on and it's grayed out. And the way that I was able to figure out how this works is because when we actually try to enable it here, it says this operation can't be used when XAVCS 4K is used, which is why most people thought you can't use it in 4K, but you can use it in 1080. But all that means is you can't use the internal 4K codec. It doesn't mean any 4K at all, which is why we have to disable the internal recording and instead use external 4K, in which case we can use it, because that's not using the internal XAVCS 4K. So we're going to put that on there. And then one last thing you need to know about Face Detect Autofocus is that you're going to want to use the, don't use things like expandable flexible spot or any flexible spots, but you're going to want to use some of the bigger things like wide. And the reason why this is that flexible spot outranks the Face Detect Autofocus, where Face Detect outranks wide. I'll give you a demonstration of that in a minute, but right now we're all set up. So I'm just going to adjust the exposure a little bit here. Okay. So face detection should be on me. You should be able to see the box and I should be sharp. And now if I get out of it, should switch to the background. And then if I come back in, the box should come back on me again and focus on my face. What if I bring it in a little bit? Come back out and jump out of the shot again and then back in. And like I was saying, this is using the wide mode. I'm going to show you what happens just in case you guys ever have this problem with face detect if you use the flexible spot. So let me just set that real quick. So if we jump down here to flexible expandable spot, which I use a lot. So I'm going to move the spot over here to the right hand side and I'm going to put myself in the left hand side of the frame. Face detection is still on, so you'll still see the box, but it won't be white. It'll turn gray and it won't focus on me even though it has a box on me because the spot overrides the face detect. Here, I'll demonstrate it now. So if I jump over here and I'm on the one side of the frame like this, and the point is over there, you'll see a box on me, but it'll be dimmer, like we said. And even if I get closer or provide a little bit of action around my face, it's not gonna focus on me no matter what I do, because it's gonna stay prioritized over there with the spot. So don't use spot focus when you wanna use face detect, because it won't work until you actually move the spot onto my face, in which case the face detection isn't really doing anything. Make sure you use wide, which is that top option on the autofocus list, wide. That's the one that you want. And that's pretty much it. That's the demonstration. That's what I was talking about in the other video. So it does work. There are definitely some limitations, and it's definitely not perfect, because if that was just a monitor, well, that was monitoring. I wasn't recording there. So that's pretty much the most you could do. You can't record on the Sony, but I could have started the recording on the Atomos. So with just a monitor, you can use the face detection, I guess, for focusing, but it's not really a full implementation of that. You're definitely gonna need an external recorder, which are generally more expensive than just a monitor, in order to be able to fully unlock that. But for those of you that have an external recorder and you couldn't get it to work and you were pretty much giving up, which is what some of you said in the comments, on these Sonys, because like the face detection doesn't work, well, it does, as long as you record externally and disable it internally. But that's gonna be it for me. I hope you found this video helpful or at least entertaining. And if you did, make sure you leave it the old thumbs up and consider subscribing if you haven't already. But if you did not find this video helpful or entertaining, feel free to hit the dislike button twice. All right, I'm done.